Hi. Suppose you are standing on the slope of a mountain with a walkie-talkie and your friend is standing on the top of the next mountain with his walkie-talkie. To make contact with your friend, you need a good reception of the signal. To have a good reception of the signal, the distance to your friend has to be as small as possible. Do you want to know where on the slope you have to stand to contact your friend? The answer is given in this video. You have to stand on the endpoint of the so-called orthogonal projection of your friend on the slope. Remember, you already learned about the orthogonal projection of a vector onto a line. This occurs, for example, when you decompose a force into two orthogonal components. The problem you are faced with now is that you want to find the orthogonal projection of a vector onto a plane in three-dimensional space. Here are the two actors in our game. Y and W. Y is a vector in R3 and W is a plane containing the origin. This is important. Before we continue, you have to recall some facts about planes and bases. You remember that a plane through the origin is spanned by two independent vectors in the plane. In other words, the plane W consists of all linear combinations of any pair of linearly independent vectors in W. Such a pair of vectors is called a basis for the plane. Now, choose an orthogonal basis for W. This is a set of two linearly independent orthogonal vectors in W. Let's call them U1 and U2. You will find out why you have to choose an orthogonal basis in a short while. You are looking for a vector y hat in W, such that the difference y minus y hat is orthogonal to the plane. Now let's first find the orthogonal projections of y onto the lines spanned by u1 and u2 respectively. You know how to do that. So denote y1 hat is the projection on u1 of y, and y2 hat is the projection on u2 of y. Then, you know that y1 hat is equal to the vector u1 scaled by the inner product of y and u1 divided by the inner product of u1 with itself. And similarly for y2 hat. It looks plausible from the figure that the y hat you are searching is equal to the sum of y1 hat and y2 hat. Don't you agree? Let's check this is indeed true. In other words, let's check that the vector z, y minus y hat, is orthogonal to W. To check that a vector is orthogonal to a plane, you check that it is orthogonal to the vectors in the basis of the plane. Rewriting z in terms of the orthogonal projections of y onto u1 and u2, you see that the inner product of the last term is equal to 0, because y2 hat is the orthogonal projection on u2, which is orthogonal to u1, because the basis is orthogonal. And the first term is 0, because the vector y minus y1 hat is orthogonal to u1. So you prove that z has inner product 0 with u1. I guess you immediately believe that this is also true for u2. So, as a consequence, you get that y hat can be written as a sum of the orthogonal projections of y onto the two lines generated by the orthogonal vectors u1 and u2. As you've seen, it is important that u1 and u2 are orthogonal, but the result does not depend on the particular choice of u1 and u2. Another thing you immediately see in this construction is that the length of the vector y minus y hat is equal to the shortest distance from y to the plane W. So, the answer to the problem we started this video with is that you have to stand on the endpoint of the orthogonal projection of your friend onto the slope of the mountain, given that you know the coordinates of two orthogonal vectors that form a basis for this slope. In class, the formula for the orthogonal projection of a 3D vector onto a plane is going to be generalized to the orthogonal projection of a vector in Rn onto a linear subspace of dimension p, thus decomposing a vector into a vector in the subspace and a vector orthogonal to this subspace. Thank you for your attention.